During primary milk processing and the production of different types of cheese, large quantities of various secondary dairy products are also obtained: whey, buttermilk, skim milk, casein nut, etc., with various solid content. Global whey production is estimated about many million tons per year, and this quantity is only 15% is processed. A possibility of nanostructuring protein systems is demonstrated based on whey electroactivation. Whey is a raw material, is not only available byproduct available in most of cheese production industry areas. It is also relatively cheap, with a higher nutritional value and several functionalities with unique properties which allow the study of nanosized structure of whey proteins. Many whey products are obtained in various countries: whey protein concentrate, whey protein isolate, whey protein hydrolysis. The solid content of whey constitutes 15% of milk, the major fraction of lactose, followed by both proteins and minerals. It is known that the whey contains over 200 components, most of them in micro and nano quantities. The electroactivation of whey allows electrofractionation of solid content, mainly the extraction of protein concentrate, protein mineral concentrate, and simultaneously isomerization of lactose and lactulose, and provide the non-residual cycle. This is our experimental membrane electrolyzer, and we obtain two major flux, protein mineral concentrate, which contain various content of protein fractions, and deprotonized whey, which contains lactulose isomerized from lactose. This is our device and products which we obtained protein mineral concentrate, deprotonized whey which contains lactulose. This is lactulose, this is concentrate of protein mineral concentrate. While applied various construction of electrolyzer and energy consumption of each of the electrolyzers is different. The basic objective of our development is development wasteless technology for processing of whey. The protein fraction extraction in PMC are high whey proteins, which contains several proteins, both in serum albumin, lactoperoxidase, lactoferrin, and complexes of higher molecular weight at approximately 200 and more. Casein fractions were defined in the alpha caseins, beta caseins, and kappa caseins, beta lactoglobulin, and alpha lactalbumin. The research of protein fractions with SDS Pudge gel 15% were determined various content of protein fractions and various regimes of processing. There are beta lactoglobulin, alpha lactalbumin, caseins, and high whey proteins. At the first 5-10 minutes, we recover the most quantity of beta lactoglobulin, but at the final process, we recover mostly of alpha lactalbumin. At the process at the processing of whey at the density current 20 milliampere per quarter centimeter. This fractionation is more widely, is more presented. At the first 5 minute, our thing maximal of recovery of beta globulin. At the final of process, we are recovery the mostly of alpha lactalbumin. In each of fractions, I present all of the essential and non-essential amino acids from various regime of processing. The recovery of beta globulin, the mechanism of recovery of beta globulin is formation by disulfide bonds and formed the cysteine as a dimer of cysteine. The alpha lactalbumin, which is the protein, small protein of molecular weight, very low, but it is increased affinity for the bivalent one of calcium and other bivalent cations. This takes place at the level of the aspartic acid that has two groups, carboxyl, that has two carboxyl groups. The recovery of higher whey protein, there are many fractions. This is lactoperoxidase, lactoferrin, and protein complex of molecular weight about 200. The recovery of caseins fractions, there are three casein fractions, is formation, but the formation of calcium phosphate caseinate complexes. The mechanism of recovery of protein fractions from whey and PMC by electroactivation depend on the action of several complexing and coagulation mechanisms. This is sedimentation and the isoelectric point, salinization of protein, formation of calcium phosphate caseinate complex, formation of protein complexes at the level of disulfide bonds, from formation of cysteine as a dimer of the cysteine, formation of protein complex from alpha lactalbumin, which has an increased affinity for the divalent ions at the level of aspartic acid. And in conclusion, whey valuable byproducts of cheese making was studied with the aim of demonstrating of a possibility of developed nanostructural system of whey. Isolation of protein fractions and the PMC at the electroactivation of the studied whey was determined by its properties at the electroactivation action. The beta globulin we recover at the first 5-10 minutes, and it quantities is about 60%. And the alpha lactalbumin we recover after the 13-25 minutes of processing, and its quantity is about 14%. And the electroactivation permit recovery more fractions of with a higher protein, higher whey proteins. It is bovine serum albumin, it is lactoperoxidase and lactoferrin. Lactoferrin were obtained in a continuous regime of electroactivation about 5%. I want to mention that the lactoferrin in whole milk is 1%, but in breast milk is 17%, and we have obtained 5-6% of lactoferrin in our concentrate, and it is very important for creating various infant formulas because lactoferrin is considered is a natural antibiotics. The casein fractions are recovered at various regime of processing from 9 to 24%, and the mechanisms of formation beta lactoglobulin and alpha lactoalbumin I mentioned early. And at finally of how I presented, I want to mention that the at various country is they need is the what is какая прибыль. What is
incomes
from various countries for buy the products obtained from whey. And I want to mention that at our JLC SR lactic plant they are obtained 24 ton whey per day, and this is very important to create wasteless processing technology for recovery from whey of various beneficial products from whey, and our technology permit recovery of protein mineral concentrate with predetermined protein content of predetermined mineral content, and simultaneously isomerization of lactose into lactulose. Thank you for attention.
Thank you very much for your presentation, very informative presentation. And questions to the reporter, dear colleagues? I have a question. It is clear that nowadays the food security for each country is a surviving problem. It is a very important, especially natural food products. Your technology, which you elaborated, will allow to increase visible in, increase the production of natural whey protein. You have tested this technology. What is your opinion on perspectives of scaling of your technology? I mean that you demonstrated the testing in laboratory conditions, this prototype, the one of the first slides which you demonstrated, it was the laboratory device installation which you elaborated and tested. Which perspectives for big production prototype to increase scale of production.
We at the VSA are presented our research at the GLC SA plant production and lactis. They are interested for our research, but they do not
Financial support.
Financial our research because they considered that the, they may buy the another technology for употребление для переработки
for protein consumption.
Our technology is very interesting because the effect is simultaneously recovery of protein mineral concentrate and isomerization of lactose into lactulose without use of chemical reagents. Electroactivation is a catalysator for this recovery of of our concentrate and simultaneously is on, I want to mention it because we are obtained lactulose simultaneously recovery of protein mineral concentrate. This is our know-how.
The biggest advantage of your proposed technology, as I listened and as I understood, it is using physical processes without any chemical reagents. It is a great advantage. That's why you have not the extra chemical reactions, which usually produce some additional products of chemical reaction. And here, without chemical reagents, using the electro physical process, you can gain the desirable product, the whey protein and minerals, just during the electrophysical process. That's why this is the great advantage of the technology. That's why I would ask you that do you know that the main purpose and main goal of new European program, I mean Horizon Europe, it is the innovation technological process, not just investigation, not just research work, but mostly most money will be invested in the projects which give a new technology and a new, especially two pylons for health and for environment. That's why this product, this is a healthy meal. That's why it is clear and visible the project in frame of one of the goals of Horizon Europe program, the project which will give money for development of this technology, not from GRC. They are a commercial farm and they would like to sell product and not for research. That's why it is difficult to gain support from the from commercial firm. That's why it is a proposal and from our conference, one of the goal of our conference to listen to and to find a new ideas, new technologies, and to help to develop them. That's why from our section is advice to you to try to find partners and to submit the proposal for this big European program, and they give big money, not a small some thousand euros from commercial firm, but big money for innovation project. Okay, it is just comment to your talk. Thank you very much once again.